Bonjour et bienvenue. Quoi de neuf? What's up guys? Comment ça va? How are you all? Aujourd'hui, nous allons continuer avec des verbes de deuxième groupe. Today, we are going to continue with the second group of verbs, that is the IR ending verbs. In last video, we covered the rules of conjugating IR ending verbs and we also discussed a few irregular verbs. I'll quickly brush you up with the conjugation part of IR ending verbs. To conjugate IR ending verbs, we have to drop R and we have to add the endings S, S, T, T, S, S, O, N, S, 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 E, Z, S, S, E, N, T. Okay. And we discussed a few irregular verbs like partir. We also discussed couvrir. We discussed venir. And a few verbs which are conjugated in the same manner as these above said verbs are conjugated. Now I am going to continue with more irregular IR ending verbs and we will see how they are conjugated. So friends, the first verb that we will cover in irregular IR verbs is courir. Courir means to run. And how we conjugate this verb is as follows. Je cours, tu cours, il court, elle court. Nous courons, vous courez, il court, elle court. So can you see the endings? They are S, S, T, O, N, S, E, Z. E-N-T. The next verb that we are going to cover is décevoir. Okay, décevoir means to disappoint. So how we conjugate this verb is as follows. Je déçois, tu déçois, il déçoit, elle déçoit. Nous décevons, vous décevez, ils déçoivent, elles déçoivent. Okay, easy. Again, the endings are S, S, T, O, N, S, E, Z, E, N, T. But you have to notice one more thing that in je, tu, il, elle and il, elle plural, the C has changed to C, cédille. The next verb that we are going to cover now is devoir. Devoir means should or must. Okay, or it shows the ability of doing something. So how this verb is conjugated is as follows. Je dois, tu dois, il doit, elle doit, nous devons, vous devez, ils doivent, elles doivent. Now, just see the irregularity in this verb. See how irregular its conjugation is. In je, tu, il, elle and il, elle plural, the radical is doi, whereas in nous and vous, the radical is dev. And the endings are s, s, t, o, n, s, e, z, e, n, t. But you really have to be conscious about the radical which is changing with the subjects. The next verb that we are going to cover is mourir. Mourir means to die. Now this verb again has very irregular conjugation. Just observe it. Je meurs, tu meurs, il meurt, elle meurt. Nous mourons, vous mourrez, il meurt, elle meurt. Again you can see with je, tu, il, elle and il, elle plural, the radical is m-e-u-r, but with nous and vous, the radical is m-o-u-r. Okay, and the endings are same as we have done till now, s-s-t, o-n-s, e-z, e-n-t. The next verb that we are going to cover is pouvoir. Pouvoir is a verb which is really used in a lot of sentences. Why? Because it shows the possibility of action to be done That means in English we can translate it as can. I can, you can, he, she can, and etc. Okay, so this verb is really, really used and we must know how this is conjugated. Je peux, tu peux, il peut, elle peut, nous pouvons, vous pouvez, ils peuvent, elles peuvent. Now, this again has irregular conjugation and the endings are also irregular. With je, tu and ilel, the radical is peu. But with nous and vous, the radical changes to pouv. And with ilel plural, the radical has altogether changed. It has become peuv. So you have to be conscious when you're learning pouvoir. And with je and tu, the endings are x. With il, it is t. Nous, ons, vous, ez. And with ilel plural, it's ent. There is another verb which is conjugated like pouvoir. And that verb is vouloir. Okay, vouloir means to want. I want, you want, etc. So let's see how vouloir is conjugated. Je veux, tu veux, il veut, elle veut, nous voulons, vous voulez, ils veulent, elles veulent. If you can see the similarity between pouvoir and vouloir, you will be able to see, first of all, the endings are same. X, X, T, O, N, S, E, Z, E, N, T. The second thing is the radical. With je, tu, il, elle, it is similar, V, E, U. With nous and vous, it becomes V, O, U, L. And with il, elle, plural, it becomes V, E, U, L. Okay? So this is how vouloir verb is conjugated. The next verb comes is savoir. Savoir means to know. Okay? And how this verb is conjugated is je sais, tu sais, il sait, elle sait, nous savons, vous savez, ils savent, elles savent. The endings are same, SST, ONS, EZENT, and the radical with je, tu and ilel is same, SAI. With nous, vous and ilel, this time all the plural radicals are same, that is SAV. Let's move to the next verb, which is servir. Servir means to serve. Okay? And how this is conjugated? Je sers, tu sers, il sert, elle sert. Nous servons, vous servez, ils servent, elles servent. This time, you can again see the singular radicals, the radicals of singular subject are same, that is S-E-R, and the radical of plural subjects are again same, which is S-E-R-V. Let's move on to the next verb, which is voir. Voir means to see. Je vois, tu vois, il voit, elle voit, nous voyons, vous voyez, il voit, elle voit. Now here we can again see the irregularity in je, tu, ilel and ilel plural. We can see the radical as voi, but in nous and vous it has become voy. Now I'm going to tell you two more verbs which end with ir, but they are called impersonal verbs. Now, what are impersonal verbs? Impersonal verbs are those verbs which are not conjugated according to the subject. What do I mean by saying that? Is, for example, there is a verb called pleuvoir. Pleuvoir means to rain. Now, we cannot say I rain, you rain, we all rain. No. This verb is conjugated only with il. And it symbolizes it rains. So it will be conjugated il pleut. Il pleut. Only il pleut will be the conjugated form of lavoir. And similarly, there is another verb which is called falloir. Falloir means to be necessary. Okay, when something is necessary to be done. This verb is also impersonal and is conjugated only with il form, only in il. Il fo. Il fo. For example, if we want to say one must do his homework. So how we are going to write this sentence in French is il faut faire son devoir. Il faut faire, faire means to do, son devoir, his or her homework. So this is how this verb is used. So this verb is also impersonal. That means we are not going to say I should do or it is necessary for me to do. No. So friends, these were a few IR ending verbs which are irregular. In next video, we are going to meet with more verbs and more rules. Till then, au revoir, prenez soin de vous, bisous bisous.